Lesson 3, Degradation of a Natural Environment, Part 2. Dear learners, hello and welcome to our program. In our previous program, we have discussed about concept of environmental degradation. Reckless exploitation of natural resources leads environmental degradation, impact of population on environment, and deforestation and its consequences, etc. Today, we will discuss about how does mining, industrialization, modernized agriculture and urbanization impact in the degradation of natural resources. I am Neelam Gupta. Welcome to the program. Objectives of the program are: discuss how mining and modern agriculture has adversely affected the environment, discuss the impact of industrialization on environment, including its biotic and abiotic resources, list local, regional and global backlashes caused by environmental degradation, describe the impact of environmental degradation on life. Impact of mining on the environment. You have already learned that earth is full of metals and mineral resources. They are very important non-renewable resources. India is very rich mineral resources. Due to rapid industrialization, mining of various metals and minerals are being intensified. That results as loss of biodiversity. Vegetation and soil are removed by using heavy machinery to get access to mineral deposits. As large areas are cleared for the purpose, it leads to loss of biodiversity of the area. Second is depletion of minerals. Earth is the rich deposit of metals and mineral resources. India has a large share of these resources. These are non-renewable resources. In last 200 years, large amount of lead, aluminium, copper and iron ore have been used. It is believed that in next 20 years, silver, tin, zinc and mercury will be depleted to an alarming level if their exploitation continues at the present rate. Next, dumping of debris, extracting of minerals from earth also produces significant amount of debris or refuse. Often it is much more than the quantity of mineral obtained. This dugout waste material is dumped on the adjacent land. Large scale logging or cutting down trees is carried out to create the space for dumping. These waste dumps also became source of soil erosion and contamination of water bodies. Next is land subsidence or landslides. Excessive mining, especially underground mining, lead to gradual sinking of the area and may also cause landslides. The landscape too is spoils. Unless care is taken, not only minerals will be depleted, but also large land area, which otherwise could be used productively, is due to dumping of mining waste. Impact of industrialization on the environment, as shown in the figure, that is, to meet the growing requirement of the increasing human population, large-scale manufacture of essential goods is necessary. Small factories to big industries have come up for mass production of goods. Industrialization is important for the development of the country. Industrialization leads to environmental degradation like the following reasons. Natural resources used as raw materials by industry are depleting rapidly. Industries generate lot of toxic gases and liquid effluents, leading to environmental degradation. Industries generate large amount of waste which pile up in the environment. Disposal of waste not only needs land but also pollutes the environment and poses hazards to human health. Industries use up a lot of fossil fuels as source of energy. Accelerated consumption of fossil fuels is depleting their stock as they are limited and non-renewable. But burning of fossil fuels releases carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, leading to global warming. Excessive nutrient, particularly nitrates and phosphates in water bodies, trigger the explosive growth of green algae called eutrophication, which may kill aquatic life. Impact of modernized agriculture on environment. It is important to achieve self-sufficiency in food production. However, intensive agriculture may lead to serious damage to the environment. Some of these are: forests are cleared to grow crops. Excessive irrigation and poor drainage causes waterlogging and kill plants. Increased use of agrochemicals such as synthetic fertilizers cause serious environmental problems. Unused fertilizers from crop lands are carried away by runoff water into lakes and rivers, causing pollution. They may also seep through soil and pollute groundwater. Use of pesticides not only kills pests but also beneficial organisms such as the insect pollinators, birds, and helpers in dispersal of seeds. Biodegradable pesticides lead to biomagnification. High yielding variety of food crops have replaced the traditional agriculture. It was based on multi-cropping, that is growing food crops, fodder and firewood crops together. This practice is replaced by monoculture, that is growing of only one type of crop. Such crops used up only a specific set of nutrients which need to be replenished repeatedly, making soil unfit for growing other crops. Urbanization means permanent settlement of people in cities. It occurs due to the following factors, that is in search of jobs, population growth and poverty in villages. Industrialization has opened many job opportunities, improved transport and communication facilities. Cultivated land was lost forever for building houses, industries, roads and other facilities. A water supply system has to be developed to provide water for drinking and other domestic uses. Growing urban population created increasing demand for potable water. As a result, availability of water became more and more scarce. Growth of cities lead to increasing demand of environmental resources. This brings about the following changes. Cultivated land was lost forever for building roads, school, or other institution and industries. Availability of water became more and more scarce as the population increases in the cities. You can see in the figure, and we experience this in our daily life also. Now comes to the next section of this program, that is environmental backlash. Learners, you must have understood, now the environment has been spoiled by humans. It has been degraded to such an extent that now humans have to suffer its backlash. You must have seen the devastation caused by nature's fury in Uttarakhand. In very few years, the natural beauty of the Uttarakhand was compromised and places of tourist interest transformed into a concrete jungle. Climate change, cloudburst, etc. are consequences of environmental degradation, and in the peak tourist season, Uttarakhand got trapped underwater from cloudbursts and flash flood, that is regional backlash. You are now familiar with the devastation caused due to various human activities. Flood, drought, acid rain, oil spill are some of common occurrence. These are largely due to carelessness and disrespect of humans towards the environment. Loss of biodiversity, global warming and ozone depletion are some of the environmental retorts and pose serious threat to human health and well-being. Backlashes are three types. One is local environmental backlashes. Now we will discuss local environmental backlash. These are, number one, salination of irrigated soil. In several areas, over-irrigation resulted in salt accumulation in the soil as water is lost from evaporation, but the salts dissolved in water remains in the soil and accumulate progressively, making the soil saline and unfit for cultivation and infertile. Next is eutrophication. Eutrophication of a water body occurs when plant nutrients such as nitrates and phosphates are released by the action of aerobic bacteria on organic waste entering a water body. These nutrients promote growth of algae, that is algal bloom. Algae consume all the oxygen and aquatic organisms die due to lack of oxygen. We have already said that to make place for growing crops, forests have been cut, fields have been developed to increase food production. Fertilizers and pesticides have been used, which has caused eutrophication due to field runoff and aquatic fauna. Excessive irrigation has caused waterlogging and killed plants. Pesticides have killed non-pests, which are pollinator or help to seed dispersal. Bioaccumulation and biomagnifications are, other consequences, and what is the exact definition of eutrophication, or how we can define eutrophication. Nutrients like nitrates and phosphates in fertilizers are washed into water bodies. Bacteria and algae in that nutrient medium grow and increase in number enormously and finish up oxygen in the water. That is eutrophication. This is an important concept. Next is Minamata disease. An interesting case in Japan was that of mercury poisoning and Minamata disease. Factories making plastics, caustic soda, pesticide, etc., release effluents in the adjacent water body. One effluent was mercury, which entered the food chain, bacteria, algae, fish, and humans. Fish died, and the poor villagers consumed them. In their tissues, mercury formed soluble monomethyl mercury and volatile dimethyl mercury and caused damage to nervous system. The high concentration of mercury in water and tissues of fish resulted for formation of soluble monomethyl mercury and volatile mercury by the action of anaerobic bacteria. Next is extinction of wildlife species. The number of tigers and lions have dwindled. The great Indian bustard is endangered, and the list of animals and plants threatened to extinction is long and growing. The Kalu River near Mumbai is severely polluted by industrial waste, and the Bombay duck, a favorite edible fish which was once common in this river, has been lost forever. Tigers and lions are being killed by sports and by poachers. We have now evidence of environmental backlash, not only at the global level, but also at the regional and local levels. Let us review some example of backlash at the regional level. In many areas, now humans are suffering the environmental backlash. Regional backlash are, one is flood. Floods are a natural disaster, and India is a flood-prone country. Floods occur almost every year during the period of monsoon. Continuously heavy rain brings huge quantities of water into rivers, which overflow and cause flood. The habitations close to the river get flooded, resulting in loss of human life and property. This means heavy economic losses. The flood affected areas suffer from quite shortage of potable water, often outbreak of epidemic diseases. Next is drought. Failure of monsoon and absence of rain leads to drought. Rise in the average global temperature due to global warming will increase water use and may create water shortage. It is estimated that a 3 degree centigrade global warming may reduce as much as 10% precipitation and creating water scarcity, leading to drought conditions. Shortage of water would adversely affect agriculture, industries, and plant communities. Animals that are unable to move to greener pasture will perish. Human will suffer from health problems. Next is acid rain. Pure rain is clear and has pH 5.6. Sulfur dioxide from coal, oxides of nitrogen from vehicles form acids with atmospheric water, fall as acid rain and ruin buildings, monuments, statues, etc. Oil spills is the next backlash. Sometimes there is accidental spill of crude oil and petroleum products into the sea by oil tankers and ships. A thin layer of oil covers sea surface, depriving marine organisms of oxygen. Floating oil slicks kill marine life and severely affect ocean ecosystem. Now we will discuss about the global backlash. Global backlash covers loss of biodiversity, global warming and greenhouse effect, etc. Now we come to the loss of biodiversity. Many herbal products for cosmetics and medicines were obtained from forest. Any wild animals were forest dwellers. Deforestation has led to loss of many species. Next is global warming and greenhouse effect. You must be experiencing a change in climate. Summers are very hot, winters colder than they used to be, and monsoons erratic. Global warming is due to greenhouse gases, especially carbon dioxide, which has accumulated in air beyond normal proportions. Global warming has caused melting of glaciers, heating up to ocean surface, leading to collapse of marine fisheries. Ozone layer depletion is one of the global issue. Layer of ozone gas protects us from UV rays from sun. The ozone layer in Earth's atmosphere prevents harmful UV radiations of sun from reaching Earth's surface. CFCs, that is chlorofluorocarbons, used in refrigeration, air conditioning, cleaning solvents, fire extinguishers and aerosols have damaged the ozone layer or ozone shield, particularly over Arctic and Antarctic regions. 30-40% reduction in the ozone layer may cause sunburn, fast aging of skin, skin cancer, cataract, cancer of retina, genetic disorders, and reduced productivity in sea and forests. Now we come to our last section, that is environmental degradation, a threat to survival. You have now learnt how various human activities have caused irreparable damage in land, air and water, and consequently to the organisms that inhabit them. Primitive humans struggled with nature for their survival, as you have read in the earlier lessons. As human beings became more civilized and through the progress of science and technology, they created various luxuries of comfortable living. But population explosion coupled with human's greed for progressive prosperity and comfort has exploited and degraded the environment mercilessly to such a large extent that human survival itself is now threatened. Contaminated food, water and air is taking its toll on human health. Toxic chemicals and harmful radiations have the potential of causing serious problems of human health. This is a picture of population explosion and causing pollution and its consequences towards the environment. A very large population means less job opportunities, unemployment and related stress. Stress may also be due to job pressure, money matters or living conditions. Diabetes, asthma, ulcers, depression, hypertension are stress-related diseases that are on the rise. Degraded quality of life and continuous health problems affects the mental health. Toxic chemicals and harmful radiations causing serious health problems like cancer, asthma, pulmonary fibrosis, pneumoconiosis are caused due to air pollution, especially in working places such as mines, textile mills, poultry, crackers, sand blasting and chemical industries. Let us now summarize what we have learned today. We have just revised what environment it is and how important it is for the humans and other organisms on Earth. But human activities have depleted natural resources and polluted the environment, as we have just discussed. Modernized agriculture practices have provided food for teeming millions, but created problems of land erosion, environmental pollution from fertilizers and pesticides. Humans have moved from villages to cities in search of better employment opportunity, education and health facilities, resulted in formation of slums which suffer from unhygienic conditions. The consequences of depleting natural resources and environment pollution are looking the face of humans. Examples are Bhopal gas tragedy, Minamata disease in Japan at the localized level, flood, drought, oil spill, etc. are regional level, and global level is represented by global warming, ozone depletion and loss of biodiversity, that is backlashes. Do you think that environmental degradation is going to cause serious problems in future? We know that due to human activities, there is scarcity of land, air and water on Earth. As more and more scientific and technical development took place, man became more and more lethargic and also more and more greedy to have more of everything. This exerted immense pressure on environment and the result was degradation. Such a huge population means more employments are to be given. The concept of safe environment was lagging behind, and today environment is taking toll on us. Let us together take the responsibility of making our environment safe and healthy for our future generations. We have borrowed the environment from our children. Let us be aware that it is a duty to preserve and conserve the environment, not merely destroy it. I hope this will enhance the knowledge of all viewers regarding environment and humans. Thank you.